स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सेम टू, ओके, सेमिस्टर टू, एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज चैप्टर नंबर 16, एंड ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ न्यू स्टोरी. सो द नेम ऑफ द स्टोरी इज द हॉर्स एंड द वुल्फ. द हॉर्स एंड द वुल्फ, इट्स द चैप्टर नंबर 16, ओके. So everybody knows what is horse and what is wolf. Both are animals. Yes or no? Okay. So both are wild animals. Okay. So let's start. As usual, I'm reading the chapter first. Once a horse named Tilly was peacefully eating green grass in the garden outside his master's house. The house was in a village and there was a forest nearby. A hungry wolf passing by saw the horse and his mouth began to water. Okay? So what the first paragraph says? That there was a horse. What is the name of the horse? It's Tilly. So Tilly is the name of a horse. What happened to that horse? That horse one day, it was grazing. That means it was eating grass, green grass in the garden. And where was the garden? That garden was located outside of his master's house. Okay? So Tilly's master's house, outside of Tilly's master house, there was a garden. And in that garden, Tilly was eating green grass. Okay, Tilly's master was living in a village, and near the village there was also a forest. So what happens? One day a wolf, he was hungry and he was passing by. While passing that forest, he saw that horse. And suddenly, instantly, his mouth begin to water. Okay? His mouth begins to watering. That means mouth watering of wolf starts. Okay? Got it? That means simple thing. There was a village and in that village a person was living and that person has a horse and the name of the horse is Tilly, and one day Tilly was eating green grass in the garden which was located outside of his master's house. So one day what happened? Near the village there was a forest and a hungry wolf, while passing that forest, he saw that horse and immediately, suddenly, by seeing that horse, the mouth of the wolf starts to water. Okay. What happens then? That's fine horse. It will taste good too. He would make a juicy stick, thought the wolf. Then wolf suddenly by seeing the horse, the wolf thinks that yes, it is a very good horse and it will taste very good also. With that horse meat, he will make a juicy stick. Juicy stick means that stick will be full of juicy. It will not be dry. It is a juicy stick. Stick means a thin slice of meat. Okay? A thin slice of horse meat. Okay? This thought comes to the mind of the wolf. Wolf thought that horse is a very good, very fine horse and it will taste also good. So with that horse meat, he will make a juicy stick. Okay, then come to the next paragraph. Look students, this is Tilly and this is that hungry wolf. Okay, the wolf approached the horse which continued to eat grass, trying to sound as pleasant as he could. The wolf said, "Good day, Mr. Horse. I see you are enjoying a meal. Is the grass good? Then wolf comes nearer to that horse. While the wolf saw the horse, then he thinks that this horse will taste good. So the wolf approaches the horse. Approached means the wolf comes nearer to horse. The wolf came nearer to that horse and with a very good voice, okay, to impress the horse, with a very good voice, the wolf said, "Good day, Mr. Horse." The wolf greets the horse by saying, "Good day." And then the wolf continues to say that, "I see you are enjoying your meal," because the horse was eating the green grass. So wolf says, "I see you are enjoying your meal." Okay, dear, can you say, the wolf asks the horse, okay dear, can you say, "Is that grass is good?" Then wolf says, "But you are looking quite pale. Are you not well?" The wolf says, ask the horse, "Is that grass is good? Then your color is looking as pale?" Pale color means without any color, okay? Without any color, very dull color, okay? Then wolf thought that and asks also, "Are you not well? You are ill?" This question comes from wolf's side to the horse, okay? Now turn the page number 106. Then what happens? His mouth full of grass, the horse replied, "Pink? Oh no, that's my natural color. I was born white and gray." By listening pale color in the voice of wolf, the horse immediately replied, though his mouth is full of grass, still the horse replied, "Eh, oh no, my dear. It's not pale color. It's my natural color because I was born with white and gray color. It's my natural. Don't say that my color is pale." Okay? Then what happens? The wolf pretended not to understand what the horse had said. He said, "I'm a doctor. I can treat you. If you tell me where the pain is, I'm sure I can cure it." When the horse says that my color is not pale, actually it is my natural color. The wolf pretended not to understand. Pretended means the wolf behaves or acts such a manner that somebody will think that the wolf thinks something. Here what happens? The wolf pretended not to understand. So the wolf reacts or acts in such a manner that the horse will think that the wolf didn't understand what the horse replied. Then immediately wolf says, "Yes, my dear, I know that you are ill because your color is pale in color. I'm also a doctor. I can treat you." So the wolf also pretends that he's a doctor. And wolf also says that, my dear horse, you just say me where you have pain. And I'm a doctor. As I'm a doctor, I will treat you and I can cure you also. Then immediately the horse became suspicious of the wolf's remarks. Whatever remark the wolf gave to the horse became suspicious. Suspicious means the horse didn't trust the wolf, didn't have faith on wolf. Okay? The horse became suspicious. That means it becomes very doubtful. Whether what the wolf has given the remark, whether it is true or false, and he didn't trust the wolf's remarks. Then thought he had better be on guard. He had better be on guard. On guard means, then a horse thought that in doubt, the horse thought that he has to be very careful. Then what happens? The wolf was now very close and the horse said, "Yes, now that I think of it. I have a painful hint food. I have a painful hint food. So the wolf then comes nearer to the horse. Then immediately the horse says, "Yes, my dear, I have a painful hind foot. It's not hind. I said that it's hind. It's hind. I have a painful hind foot. Hind foot means I have a pain on the back side of my foot. It has been swollen for ages. Before many more days, it has been swollen. Okay? So swollen means जैसे आपका पैर फूल जाना उसका, so the foot of the horse it was swollen. Then the wolf trotted up to examine the hoof which the horse had blindly raised into the air. Then the wolf trotted up. Trotted up means the wolf walked very. The wolf walked. Taking very short steps, okay? Taking very short steps, the wolf walked towards the horse to examine the hoof. Hoof means the hard part of the foot of an animal. Because the horse had said that on the back side, on the high back side of his foot, it has a pain. So to examine that, the wolf walked very slowly by taking very short steps. He walked towards the horse. Then immediately the horse had oblongly raised into the air. Oblongly raised into the air. That means to show its food, to help the wolf to show it, because the wolf is coming to examine it, the foot. So the horse raised its foot into the air. The wolf thought that the horse is showing. But what happens? When the horse was certain that the wolf was near enough, he gave a mighty kick. What happens? When the horse becomes very damn sure that the wolf is very closer to the horse gives a very strong kick to the wolf. The wolf went flying in the air. The wolf went flying in the air. That means the wolf was thrown very up in the air. "Would you like to examine me again?" said the horse. Then horse asks to the wolf, "Would you examine again? You are ready to examine me?" The wolf struggled to his feet. Then his head was spinning and he was seeing stars in the daytime. As the horse gives a strong kick to the wolf went up in the air and his head was spinning and he saw the stars in the daytime. Then the horse asks, "Still you are ready to examine me?" The wolf answers, no, my dear, no. "That's enough for one day." Then wolf said, that's enough for one day. He mumbled and went limping home with no more thoughts of heavy horse steeds. Then what happens? The wolf said, "No, my dear horse, I don't want to examine you. For today it is way enough." And he mumbled very unclearly. He said all these things and he goes back to his home without any thought of having the horse sticks, without any thought of eating the meat of the horse. So this is the story. Okay, this is the explanation phase, and in the next class we will do the exercise section. Till then, bye bye.